Hardtail mountain bikes are not only really fun and responsive, but they're also great when you're on a budget. I get asked all the time, what's a good budget hardtail? And that's all gonna depend on what exactly your budget is. For example, if your budget's like unlimited, this would be a great hardtail to get. I know this is not the video you need right now. The world's coming to an end, inflation, recession. But I started planning this months ago. Back in July, I commissioned Sage, a titanium frame builder in Oregon, to build me exactly the frame that I wanted. It even has a custom paint job that only covers some of the frame so you can see the raw titanium and the welds. I worked with a professional frame builder to design and build it. I painstakingly chose every single part that is going on the bike, and now it's here. And we could talk about this bike all day, but before we do that, let's build it. So why titanium? Titanium's extremely durable, it's lightweight, it's very resistant to fatigue, it can last a lifetime. Working with titanium is pretty tricky. It requires a very clean space, plenty of shielding gas, and an extremely steady and experienced hand. And what you end up with are the sickest looking welds ever. So I've been looking forward to building this for months. I'm gonna savor it. First, I'm gonna do the boring stuff like peeling the stickers off the fork so I can color match it, mounting the tires and adding sealant, just prepping all the time-consuming items. Then I'm gonna make sure all the bearings are in place, and then we get to the fun stuff. E-wings. E-wings are titanium cranks. They remind me of old BMX cranks. They're just gorgeous. They're super stiff, super strong, and super light. But that's not all. They're 165 millimeters. Almost any bike you buy is gonna have cranks between 170 and 175 millimeters. Rarely do they make them this short, but I'm really short. And so custom bike, you get to choose all the parts. These are gonna be ideal for me. These Fox stickers are not the flavor of blue that I thought they would be, but we'll see what it looks like on the bike and we can change them. To preload the bearings in this headset, it's not getting a star nut, it's getting a threadless carrier for a one-up EDC. It's a tool that I can use for repairs that's always gonna be with me. Why carbon? Why not titanium bars on a titanium bike? Well, the answer is ride quality. These bars flex just a little bit in all the right places. That's what they're known for, and so I think it's gonna pair really well with this titanium frame. This bike uses a UDH, it's a universal derailleur hanger. What that means is that if you're a bike company and you don't wanna engineer your own derailleur hanger, you can use the UDH, and then when you go into a bike shop, they're gonna have it because it's universal, there's one. I had to take the bottom bracket out to run the brake hose. Live and learn. I almost never do frame protection, and when I do, it's just on the chainstay. But the rest of the bike, we're gonna let it wear in just like any other. We are almost at the point now where we get to stare at this bike, but I have one problem.
Whose fault is that, Oscar?
Well, my fault, of course. I should have put that foam tubing around the brake hose, but now I have to take all this apart, take the bottom bracket out, but I found a hack. This guy on YouTube posted a solution 2 years ago, and it's pretty brilliant. Now, he's a road biker with a carbon frame, same difference. We're gonna go to the hardware store, get gap filler rod, drill holes in it, and then make a little slice, push them down into the frame, and we have a lightweight, very clean solution to stopping the cable from rattling. And then we have a nice mild 50 degree day that I think we can stare at this bike in. First things first, here's my existing hardtail, my carbon one, with all the batteries, pedals, one-up EDC, 26 pounds, 6 ounces. So of course you wanna know what the new one weighs. Same thing, batteries, pedals, one-up EDC, 26 pounds, 7 ounces. So the new bike actually weighs an ounce more. If I had fresh sealant in the old bike, they'd probably weigh exactly the same. Why doesn't the new bike weigh significantly less? And the answer is, titanium's heavier than carbon. And so I didn't choose titanium because it's the lightest material. I chose it because it's the strongest. This will last my entire life. I can get it repaired infinitely. And to be frank, it's easier to find somebody that builds custom titanium frames than it is carbon frames. And it looks sick. And you know what else is sick? Me. Yeah, I woke up Monday morning with COVID, and so it'll be another few days before I can tell you the most important thing about this bike, how it rides. But you probably wanna know what it costed. And a lot of that would depend on what you purchased each of these parts for. The prices are changing fast right now. It seems to be north of $12,000 and south of $14,000. Now, the frame itself was designed and built by Sage. It's a company in Oregon. They had a bike called the Powerline that was very, very similar to what I wanted. So we started with the Powerline as the platform, and we altered the lengths of the tubing and the angles to get it exactly how I wanted. Now, when you're choosing the geometry of a bike, you're trying to decide in what conditions and at what speed the bike performs best. A big enduro bike can be a little bit of a handful when you're just pedaling it around, but once it gets up to speed, it handles amazing. Cross-country bike comes alive the second you put your foot on the pedal, but at really high speeds, it can get sketchy. A trail bike sits right in the middle, and this trail bike is skewed more towards the cross-country end. Not much. This is gonna be for actually covering some ground and exploring. Hence the paint job, Blue Ridge Camo. It's a camouflage in the shades of the Blue Ridge Mountains because this is for getting lost in the mountains. And actually, the painter also makes knives, and so he made me a knife that perfectly matches my bike. And so, I don't know, maybe I'll mount this to the bike somewhere for self-defense. Hidden within the Blue Ridge Camo are quite a few Easter eggs. We'll take a closer look at those next time, as well as a lot of other details like the geometry. Now, in the main triangle over here, you can see I've got two bottle cages. It's very hard to find a bike with two bottle cage mounts when you're the smallest size because the bolts would go right into your dropper post. And so these mounts jut out a little bit from the frame, and we had custom bolts made that just stop right before the seat post. But that's not the only mount we put on the frame. We put one right here in front of the seat on the top tube. And I can do with that mount whatever I want. Now, you've seen sometimes I like to put a GoPro right there. That's the first thing I did was I designed a GoPro mount that fits right here on the top tube. I'm gonna design all sorts of stuff with this. I'm gonna have a blast with it. The power line is made for a 130 millimeter fork, which I have on here. And as you can see, it's a Fox Factory 34. I chose that fork because in my opinion, it's one of the best forks you can buy, period. It's light, it's easy to service, it's reliable. Another important part, the wheels. I went with Bird wheels. I tested those on my last hardtail and loved them. Bird wheels have polyethylene spokes. It's like a fabric. It makes the wheels extremely lightweight and it gives them a certain ride characteristic that I love. Also worth noting, these are 29-inch wheels. That would make this my first 29er besides the Kent Travail. Now up front, I have a Maxxis Minion because that's my go-to tire, but at the rear, I have a Maxxis Recon, and this is a little bit faster rolling, lighter weight. I think it's a good mix of tire for the types of things that I'm gonna be doing on this bike. Moving outwards, we have TRP Evo Trail Brakes. No surprise there, I love TRP brakes. I like the feel of the trigger. They have plenty of power. I have a 200 millimeter rotor up front and a 180 in the rear, as you would expect on a bike like this. Something you may not have expected was the rev grips. Rev grips kind of move a little bit and you can actually adjust how much they move by adding or removing tuning washers. I made fun of the rev grips for being gimmicky and expensive when I first reviewed them. But the audience pushed back hard. There were tons of devout rev grip users among you and you convinced me to give them an honest try and I've come to really like them. Of course, I've got SRAM access through and through. Dropper post, drivetrain, cassette. That pretty much goes without saying. And as I mentioned, the drivetrain is mated to Cane Creek E-Wings, not your run-of-the-mill crankset. Some of the strongest cranks out there. Probably the only downside is that they cost about as much as a bike. Now on the ends of these cranks are the Sensus crew pedals. I just wanted something really special, and the crew pedals are very uncommon. I love the way they look. They're super light, they have titanium spindles. They should be super durable and super smooth. I wanted a bike that was gonna be really distinctive, that I was gonna be excited to ride, and that looked like nothing else out there. And you wouldn't believe how bummed out I was when I woke up Monday with COVID, because that was the plan. I was gonna ride this bike all day. Pretty much like worked my entire life for this, is the way that you could look at it. And so I'm excited to ride it, and we're gonna do that next time and test it in every type of scenario. I'm pretty excited about this, and so I'm releasing a Blue Ridge jersey, same colors as the Blue Ridge Mountains. 3/4 sleeve, it's extremely comfortable, and we're gonna make every effort to get it to you before Christmas or Hanukkah. We also have our e-t-shirts and a variety of other garments. And if you're getting it for yourself, don't get it to support me, get it because you deserve it. Thanks for joining me today. I hope you'll join me next time when we actually test this bike. And thanks for riding with me today. I'll see you next time.